Diet can be a dirty word for plenty of us, and it's no wonder with the world of dieting often being pretty confusing. There are so many fad diets out there, and they claim to help you kick those kilos, but do they actually work? Well, there's been a diet that's been sweeping the globe, and people claim it does. It's the 5-2. You've probably heard of it. And here to help explain the science behind it and why it might be the one for you is trainer Shannan Ponton. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
I have stacks of friends who swear by this diet. They say it works for them. What is the science behind the 5-2? What is it exactly?
I can't believe the emotion that surrounds dieting. Even walking through the halls of Channel 10 this morning, I've had at least 15 or 20 people come up to me and go, Shannan, you've got to tell me, does it really work?
Yeah.
They want to know. So there's a growing mass of studies that support IF. Now, IF simply is intermittent fasting.
Okay.
Which, exactly as the name says, is a short period of calorie restriction.
Yep.
Now, I know I'm a skeptical as anybody else about studies and believe you can find a study just about to prove or disprove anything.
Mm-hmm.
But it's the philosophy and the theory behind intermittent fasting that I found so exciting. And that's why the 5-2 diet, I believe, is going to take things to the next level.
So 5-2 means for 5 days you eat normally.
Yep.
And for 2 days you restrict calorie consumption to just 500 calories for women.
Now, I know you sounded horrified when you said that, Sarah, 500 calories.
It's like a burger. It's like one burger, right?
If we could just have a look at this half of the table. This is your 500 calorie fasting day.
Well, let's go through
this. This is
foods.
How much we're overdoing it.
You spread it out, though.
So half a piece of toast with some egg white omelette.
Yeah, and just make that up as an omelette.
A yogurt?
Yeah, no sugar yogurt. A chicken breast and 2 cups of veggies. An orange. A small tin of tuna in spring water and 2 cups of salad.
So it's not really starving yourself, it's just severely restricting.
So that's the fast diet.
No, I think this is where we're wrong. Our society's gone to this point of absolute decadence. And the best thing about intermittent fasting is not just the weight loss benefits, mm-hmm. it's the primal kickstart that we get to stop diseases. Now, type 2 diabetes, cancer and autoimmune diseases are on a frightening rise. Whatever we're doing at the moment is not working. Man. Our nation prides itself on being fit and healthy, and over 66% of our nation is overweight or obese.
Okay.
So what we've got going on at the moment's wrong.
So can I ask if you were eating that? That's your diet.
Your 2 days.
Your 2 days, yeah.
Can you have a coffee with sugar? Or no, does that throw the whole thing out?
You could have a black coffee, could you?
You could have a black coffee, definitely.
Right.
Yeah, but very low calories.
Could you put salt and pepper on that and maybe lemon juice?
Yeah, I think part of the rewarding satisfaction that I get from following 5-2 diet is the ability of not compromising.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody wants to go, oh, but can I add this? Can I add that? Can I add this? To get anything worth doing, there must be some commitment and some sacrifice.
Yeah.
That gives you empowerment around food. It puts you back in control.
Mm.
The other thing is nobody's selling anything here. I haven't got Shannan Super 5-2 diet powder. I'm not sending anybody else to buy $500 worth of shakes before you get started.
Mm.
This is just healthy, nutritious food. But we've got to get our eating under control.
Can I ask a quick question, though? Because this is what you're supposed to be eating on the other 5 days. So the other 5 days, if you're eating on the 5-2 diet, doesn't mean that you can then slam McDonald's for 5 days. You've got to eat relatively healthy, right?
Yep.
But when it comes to the fasting days, I always thought that your body, if you stop eating, that your body shuts down, it doesn't burn calories, that it says you need to stockpile your calories and your fat because you've gone into starvation mode. Doesn't that happen?
I think that's a little bit of an old wives' tale.
Is it?
If you tell anybody that's starving, if you take what the Australian prisoners of war looked like at the end of World War II, on the end, no one of them are going, I can't lose these last couple of kilos off my backside.
Yeah.
I've got the fat gene or I've gone into shutdown mode.
Okay.
Human body, if you don't eat too much, and you exercise, we'll lose weight no matter on what type of body you are or what restrictions you've got.
I actually have 2 quick questions. When you eat that way, are you starving or does it, you know, something click in where you're
it's actually a fast, that's far from starving.
Yeah, right.
What it does, it gives you an element of control around food. You know, the human race is a classic hunter-gatherers where you ate well, if you hunted well, and if you didn't hunt well, you didn't eat. And that your body would be forced into survival mode then. But what it would do is increase your ability to fight disease, offset hunger and all that sort of stuff, which is what we're getting when you do your intermittent fasting days.
Sorry, I've got another quick question. They always say eat breakfast, but then I also hear that starving till midday the next day is better for your body.
Fasting.
Well, I still believe that this is broken up perfectly into 4 meals of the day plus a snack. Oh, sorry, 3 meals a day in
so
snacks.
You eat
so you've
your
got
breakfast,
lunch, dinner, and then either one of these snacks, whichever you prefer.
And what about if you're going out at night? How do you do a restaurant? Just steak and veggies?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, even you can go out, most places are going to give you chicken
breast.
Steak,
you've got to have pork. That's pork.
Yeah, much better.
Much better than beef.
Right. Well, you just get
hardly any calories in pork.
You just get much more bang for your buck.
Yeah.
And that's the idea. You know, here you're getting a lot of bang for your buck for your 500. No one is ever, ever going to starve on this. You've got to eat this for just about forever.
On the 2 days of fasting, do they need to be consecutive days or can you break them up? Say, could you do it on a Monday and a Thursday and then that way you could have your weekends to have a bit of a blowout?
The most sustainability I've got from this diet and the best way that I've found to make it attractive to everybody is to start with three phases. So on phase one, you align your 500 calorie days on non-consecutive days. So example, Tuesday and Thursday.
Yep.
Once you get that under control, because you've got to be kind to yourself, getting your appetite under control is like training, fitness.
So you've got to
get control, you've got to ease into it. You don't just run a marathon. The same with this, you ease into it. Once you get control of that, you go to phase two. On that phase two, align your two 500 calorie days consecutively. So you might go Wednesday, Thursday. Then if you really want to get into it, you align your two 500 calorie days consecutively, but take the calories out on one day, and that becomes a water only day.
Mm. Can now, you have that's a glass not something. Of wine?
No way.
No way.
That's
never.
Not something you
not
do every
water.
Day. Yeah, it's not something you do every week, but maybe once a month, because getting down to that level is really going to kickstart your body's primal self-response mechanism.
Before we see results.
Straight away.
Wow.
Straight away. It's one of those things that in this society we want instant gratification and instant reward, you know. Mm. And coming off that fasting day is one of the most rewarding things I've done. I've always felt fantastic.
Yeah. And do you overeat on those normal days?
Well,
he doesn't.
I still believe, even with all this going on, I believe there's a place for one cheat meal per week for longevity.
Yeah.
And could you do this and not train?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely. Right. But we know that training and nutrition go together for the best, you know, the best effect. Yeah. But the 5-2 diet goes far beyond just getting your weight under control. It's lowering your blood pressure, it's lowering type 2 diabetes, it's lowering blood lipids, mm-hmm. it's increasing your body's growth hormone, it's anti-cancer. It decreases your hunger. It's all those things away from weight loss that I find most exciting.
Probably best to check with your GP before embarking on any sort of diet, particularly if you are pregnant or if you have any medical conditions. Shannan Ponton,
yep.
Seems like a pretty good diet. Thank you.
Who's up for it?
Yeah.